Time for Minor League Baseball here on the show as we set our sights on the AA Eastern League. A critical one in store for us here. It's game one between the Reading Fightin' Phils and the Portland Sea Dogs. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Jay Groom, a southpaw from New Jersey, gets the starting gig in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So striding in, Tom Gutierrez, and we are set for baseball here this evening. And that misses, 2-1. And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Now here's the pitch. Hit back up the middle. And this goes right through him. And how about that to start a game?
Well, I was interested to see what he was going to do in a 3-1 count. Was he willing to take it full, work the pitcher a little bit more? Or because he had count leverage, was he going to come unglued? They have an aggressive plan today. This pitcher is going to have to be on top of his game.
Stepping in now, Jose Antequera. Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him. A ball and two strikes. Here's a look over to first. Runner's back. Gutierrez aboard here at first with nobody out. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And foul, though it had the home run distance. The 1-2. It swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
To the plate now, Logan Forsythe. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Tries to go the other way as this is hit in the air down the right field line. And that's in there. Base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
The right fielder, number 6, Danny Mayer.
Into the box, Danny Mayer. Hit out towards second. One there. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
They couldn't turn the inning-ending double play. They just get the force out at second, and the runner scores from third.
Stepping into the box, Derek Paul, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Two out with the man at first. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Nip the corner, 2-2. Line, but speared on a hop. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. Reading is out in front here, 1-0.
J.
Jojo Romero, the southpaw out of the Golden State, gets the call here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
Marco Hernandez steps in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Swing and a foul tip, but that's held onto behind the plate. It's a strikeout for out number one.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
At the plate now, Brett Netzer. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. One out, nobody on. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Into the box now, Ken Platt. Smoked on the ground left side, and that's through for a hit.
He looked a little bit out in front right there, but he's able to pull that ground ball through the hole for a single.
In now, Jaron Duran. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Fouled away. Platt is off of first with two away. Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulder. Side retired. One hit, one left. We'll go on to the top of inning number two. Redding leads it 1-0. New inning set to get underway, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Jose Gomez. The 1-1. Taken, strike two.
I'm absolutely shocked he took that pitch right there. Right in the wheelhouse, low 90s heater. That's one you've got to let go on.
Still 1-2. The pitch. Hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second.
Batting seven, the catcher, Nerlui Martinez.
Into the box now, Nerlui Martinez. Bases are empty, one man out. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. To two balls and two strikes now. On the ground to the right side. And that's the second out. Now at the plate, Josh Steven. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. This is line to left, and that is in there for a two-out base knock. So the two-out base hit on the top of the inning is still alive.
What a nice piece of hitting right there. Didn't try and do too much. Stayed on the attack, kept his hands inside the ball, and took what the pitcher gave him.
Two Stepping in now, Raul Rivas. A bouncer up the middle. Scooped up. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. Redding is out in front here, 1-0. Last half of the second set to go, and next to hit is the catcher, Austin Rye. Not where you want the changeup, but he gets away with it for a strike.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out. Now batting, Dylan Hardy. Hit well on the ground to first. And he can't come up with it. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Batting back, the third baseman, Jansen Whitty.
To the plate now, Jansen Whitty. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. Hardy leads off first with one away. Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Batting it.
Now with the plate, Nick Lovello. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Hello.
A runner on first with two away. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Tom Gutierrez. He singled his last time up. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground to short. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Jose Ontiveros.
At the plate, Jose Antequera. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Heading out towards shallow right. Duran will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. So a runner at first with one man gone. And up next, the veteran middle infielder, Logan Forsythe. The 1-1 home.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Back up the middle. And that gets through for a one-out base hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in. Kept his hands inside the baseball and ripped the base hit up the middle.
If you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
At the plate now, Danny Mayer. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
A lot of indecision there on that check swing, and that's something you see quite a lot on three and two. When the difference between striking out and drawing the walk and can be an inch or two, it's pretty understandable why guys aren't always aggressive with their swings.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Gutierrez at second. Forsythe on at first with two down. Slice down the left side, but foul.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Pulled toward right center field. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the switch hitting outfielder, Daner Lopez. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Off speed pitch, just missed inside. To third, fielded cleanly. And the throw to first is in time, one gun. Now at the plate now is the designated hitter, Marco Hernandez, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Throw in time at first for out number two. Digging in for his second at bat, Brett Netzer. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Swing and he pulls the fastball high in the air toward deep right center. Gutierrez is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. All set for the start of the fourth, and set to go is the third baseman, Jose Gomez. Struck him out.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that. And as a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you can do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
So now to the plate, near Luis Martinez. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
One out, nobody on. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
The left fielder, number five, John.
At the plate, Josh Steven, 1-for-1 after a single his first time up. A double play ball to second. 4-6-3, but it's not in time, and the inning will continue.
The batter, number 9.
Coming to the plate now, Raul Rivas. Ball and two strikes, here it is. Tried to hold up there, appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. Now a swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Platt is there and the side is retired. So it's no runs, no base hits, no errors, and a runner left. To the bottom of inning number four we go. Redding leads it 1-0. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next it'll be the switch hitting first baseman, Ken Platt. Here now the 2-2. Lined in the right, a base hit.
Well, you see that happen quite a bit at the big league level, D-Lo. Breaking ball up and away, hit for a bullet for a base hit.
Yeah, Dan, you try and look for it to pop out above the pitcher's hand. That usually signifies that it's going to be something breaking. That was actually a slider, so nice job by the offensive player, not only recognizing it, but not trying to do too much.
Into the box now, Jaron Duran. This is driven to right, and no doubt about it, that one's way out of here. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, his first homer here in the series. As they take the lead, it's 2-1.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
In now, Austin Wright. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Well, giving up hits is one thing, but judging by that last pitch, he doesn't have any consistency with his release point right now. He doesn't know where it's going, and he knows it.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
Standing in now, Dylan Hardy. Down low, 2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. He's got it. And there's out number two. Settling in now, Jansen Whitty. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Bases are empty here with two men out. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. Three and one now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 3-2 pitch is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. We're through four, and it's now a 2-1 ball game. Leading off the inning, Tom Gutierrez, and they'll need him to get something going here. No offer on that one. 2-2.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Popped up. Platt is right there. One gone.
Now the batter.
Ready once again, Jose Antequera, 0 for 2 for him to this point. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hardy is there now, and he has it, two gone.
The batter
ready for another shot now. Logan Forsythe, a couple of singles to his credit thus far. Lifted in the air toward the line and right, and foul. Line to the right side, and that'll get down for a two-out single.
Hey, not a bad way to start the nightcap. Three at bats, three base hits, D-Row.
Yeah, the pressure falls off you after you go one for one. Two for two, all smiles. Three for three, get the party started.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Danny Meyer, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Here it comes on 1-1. Hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Right fielder is on the run. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. Forsythe rounds the corner and is headed home. He comes across to score. It's a 2-2 game.
Great piece of hitting here. Men on first, and they're playing in the pull, but he crosses them up and goes the other way with it, making the outfielder cover a lot of extra ground. That allowed the runner to come all the way around from first to score, and that was a great piece of hitting.
To the plate now, Derek Hall. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of getting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Throws him for strike three, and that retires the side. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. Bottom of the fifth coming up, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Nick Lovello. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway.
And this is exactly what you want to do when you're trying to put a start away. Make him work his tail off, throw a lot of pitches, and get on base any way that you can. A big inning at this point of the game, and he's probably gone.
2-2 is our score. Leadoff man aboard at first here with nobody out. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Steven will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Stepping up now, Marco Hernandez. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first base line. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And, hey, a strikeout always works, too.
Stepping in now, ball even at 2-2.
I know that's the spot he didn't want to miss in, but he got away with it.
Set to deal on 2-2. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He can't get there as it falls in. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double.
Now that, the home baseman,
plate now. Ken Platt. Pitch popped up. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two men left on. We're through five here at the ballpark, and we are tied 2-2. Brian Mata takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the T-Dogs, number 90, Brian Mata.
Now to the plate, Jose Gomez. The 1-1. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
And there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
At the plate, near Luis Martinez. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. All even now, 2-2. And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
The next 3-2. This is pulled into right. Duran back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Boy, sometimes they say you hit it hard, good things will happen. Well, that's not the case right there. That was a bullet that just stayed up and is caught in the outfield.
In now, Josh Steven, a hit and two tries for him so far. Now the 2-1 pitch. The count now at 2-2. Now the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Brandon Liebrand enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 28, Brandon Liebrand.
Digging in and looking for more, Jarren Duran comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier.
The last at bat, Matty V, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
The 1-2. Fouls this one off. And now a ball hit pretty well down that right field line. This has some carry to it, and it is gone. Home run. A solo shot down the line in right. His second of the game. As they have taken the lead, it's now 3-2.
second home run of the game right there. He is locked in at the plate. You hear so many of today's players talk about rhythm and timing. Well, he is perfectly on time in the heart of the zone.
Into the box, Austin Wright. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting.
At the plate, Dylan Pardy. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. A 1-1. He's up and in, but called a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Here's a little chopper up the middle, and this is knocked down on the mound. Thankfully, he's able to recover, and he gets the second out at first.
Now batting, third baseman.
Digging in, Jansen Witte. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. And now a pitch on the way. And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. 2-2 one more time. Skied into very shallow right. Mayer is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. So only one hit in the inning on the solo shot, but it's enough to push him out in front. On to the seventh here in game one. The Sea Dogs lead it 3-2. Standing in, Raul Rivas. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
1-2 now. And the pitch. Fouled off. Now another 1-2. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Now here's the pitch.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
Another one sent foul. The 1-2. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Pardy comes on now, and he has it, one down.
The center fielder, number
so the lineup flips over, and digging in, Tom Gutierrez. He's 2-for-3 thus far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a breaking ball, but it's low. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Fastball in there, 3-2. Full count still. One out, nobody on. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
Now batting.
Striding into the box, Jose Antequera. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. The pitch. High in the air out to center field. Pardy will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side.
Here comes the traditional 7th inning.
Last half of the seventh here, and stepping up as the shortstop, Nick Lovello. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the seventh.
Now back, left fielder, Jader Lopez.
Into the box now, Daner Lopez. Not where you want the changeup, but he gets away with it for a strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering it pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
In now, Marco Hernandez. And my goodness, that nearly got him as he had to back away from it. It's ball three.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent, beware.
Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
It's been a rough night at the yard for him. That's three times he's gone down on strikes in this one. So they've really figured out how to attack this guy.
Standing in now, Brett Netzer. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Again, he sends it out of play. Lunging at a changeup that time, and he pops it up near second. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Adam Lau has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 37, Adam Lau.
Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Logan Forsythe. Ready with the 1-1. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Looking up is the left fielder. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo shot here to left, as it's now a 3-all ball game.
Big time at bat right there. Team trailing, and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
At the plate now, Danny Mayer, and it's fouled away. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
We know he's probably still thinking about that game-tying home run he just gave up. But I'm going to give him credit for not showing that it's bothering him. When you come back and strike out the next guy, it shows you've still got your head in the right place.
To the plate now, Derek Hall. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. 2-1 home is a changeup that's looked at for a ball. Jose Gomez is on deck. Set. Here's the 3-1. And a dive, but it rattles in and out of the glove.
Hey guys, that's an excellent job right there. That's a back foot slider. Usually those are kryptonite for most batters, and he's able to fight it off, keep his hands inside the baseball, and deliver a base hit.
Into the box, Jose Gomez. Look out, a fastball up near his dome, and that'll wake you up a bit.
That's a classic piece of pitching right there. You have to back hitters away from the plate to make them a little bit uncomfortable. Now you can go inside or outside. I like that purpose pitch.
The 2-1 home is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box now, Nerluis Martinez. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. This is pulled into right, but a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field for the final out of the inning. But the tying run has come across here as we're set up for an exciting finish. Home half of the eighth straight ahead, and we are all tied at 3 apiece. Bottom of the inning now, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Ken Platt. The 1-1. Swing and a liner, and he dives, but he can't make the play. It lands foul. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. 2-2.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
That's popped up. Forsythe ranging into shallow right. He's there and records the first down. Stepping up to the plate, Jaron Duran. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Bases are empty, one man out. And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
Stepping in now, Austin Wright. Swinging a ground ball to third. Right to him. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. So nothing happening this time around. We're on to the ninth here in game one. And we are all tied at 3 apiece. Edgar Jimenez will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ball game tied until the bottom half. Stolen Stepping into the box, Josh Steven. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now. Drilled to the left side. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Adapt and persevere. That's what I always said on the offensive side. Down in the count right there. Batter hits a ground ball the other way. He's able to fight off a tough count and get himself a base hit.
Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And he's back standing. In now, Raul Rivas.
At the
ball two.
Back down 2-2.
Got him.
The center fielder.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tom Gutierrez. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. The 1-1 pitch. Took him right up the ladder that time, and it's 1-2.
It's funny. That pitch, I can picture being in the box. That pitch looks so good to hit, and why does no one ever get to it? A good executed high fastball usually blows 9 out of 10 guys away.
Whitty camps under it, and he's got it for out number two. Coming to the plate now, Jose Antequera. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Popped him up. Netzer has got it, and the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. Sixth, seventh, and eighth place hitters scheduled to start the bottom of inning number 9. And we are all tied at 3 apiece. So stepping in, Dylan Hardy. He was a ground-out victim last time up. The 2-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number 2. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hit in the air to right field. Mayer is there, and that is a big first out here to start inning number 9.
Now batting.
Into the box, Jansen Whitty, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he popped him up. Back into foul territory behind first, and that's going to land foul. Fouled away. One out, nobody on. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
It's a fine line for working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance of getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
And he fouls this one off. Hit hard toward the right side. And it gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Hey, nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. I know there's one out in the inning. They got one more to play with that they could potentially be productive with, but this guy's looking to end this right now and put something in a gap.
At the plate now, Nick Lovello. This is line to left, and he might have done it. Can they score that runner from first? And he will make it into second base as the winning run is in scoring position now with only one away.
Not really much the pitcher can do about that one. He put the ball down in the zone where he wanted it, but it was just a solid piece of hitting. Goes down and gets it and pulls it into the corner for extra bases.
Yeah, as you know, Dan, sometimes the hitter just wins. Kyle Doey is called upon to get the final two outs of the ninth and send this one into extra innings. Into the box now, Daner Lopez. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Possible winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's one and two.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
Now the one and two pitch. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. Oh, and I think that got him in the foot. Throw to the plate, and he is out at the plate. Taking a chance, trying to end the ball game, but instead, there are now two away.
Sort of a daring move there going for the plate, but it didn't pay off. It was hit softly, but it gets scooped up quickly and fired home on target. Ideally, you want to go home like that on a ball that's hit beyond the pitcher's mound.
Standing in, Marco Hernandez. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0 for 4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Now the 2-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Steven will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, and we are all tied at 3 apiece. We are into extra innings, and up next, the veteran middle infielder Logan Forsythe.
And that last at bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
Lays off 2-2 now. Line towards center field. Hardy is right there, one down.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Danny Mayer. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Weak grounder down the line at third, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Pitch on the way. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
At the plate, Derek Paul. Lifted down the line and left. Lopez is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. So they go quietly here in this half inning. So one will win it here as we go to the bottom of inning number 10. And we are all tied at 3 apiece. Digging in once again, Brett Netzer. He got under one and popped out his last time up. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Swing and a liner. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit.
Love the approach right there to get on base with a leadoff knock to start the bottom of the 10th. They don't want this game to go any farther than this. They want to end it right now. Let's see how the manager plays this.
So now to the plate, Ken Platt. And he'll try and get that winning run into scoring position as he puts this one down. Only play will be to first, so there you go. The possible winning run is into scoring position now on the sacrifice. Jaron Duran will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, we take you back to inning number 6. This was his second home run of the ball game as he'll stand in here looking for number 3. Now the 2-1. Trying to bunt here, but this winds up hitting him. And they're going to say that he went after it. A strange strike, too. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter, you think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Standing in now, Austin Wright. Swung out and missed. 1-2 now.
Well, he's hoping to be a hero and drive in the winning run, but that swing tells me he's a little too amped up. You don't chase a pitch that badly if you're playing within yourself.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
And this ball is raked deep down the line in left. But he just missed his extra bases. Ready with another two-strike offering. Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. And this is popped up near second base.
Forsyth
is there to make the catch, and that means we've got more baseball ahead. Now at the plate, Jose Gomez struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. On the ground to the left side, scooped up, throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away. At the plate, near Luis Martinez. He's hitless in 3 at bats to this point. The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off. Ball 4. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at-bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
Digging in now, Josh Steven. On the night, he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles. The 1-1 pitch. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and 2 strikes now. in the dirt here, and a heads up play to get back to first as he wisely hadn't gotten too far from the bag. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Swing and a liner. So he'll add one to his total as that falls in. He's got three hits in this one.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
To the plate now, Raul Rivas. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Here he is in his third inning of work out of the pen, which isn't all that common these days. And he's looking a little off right now. These guys aren't used to getting this much work in a single game anymore.
Now the 2-1. Here's a swing and a miss, and that, folks, is a big out number two.
Big strikeout for the second out there, but he's not out of it yet. We'll see if he can feed off that K, wiggle out of the jam, and keep this game tied.
In now, Tom Gutierrez down the third baseline. Swing and a liner, but pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. No runs, a hit, two left. It's getting late. One run can win it as we move to the bottom of the 11th, and we are all tied at three apiece. Set now for the bottom of the 11th, and digging in is the outfielder, Dylan Hardy. Fastball well outside.
Count 2-1.
Now the 2-1.
Ball, that's down.
Popped him up. Forsythe is there for it. Makes the play, one away. Now in the box, Jansen Witte. It was a single for him in his last at bat. The 1-1 home. It is strike two, swinging.
One ball, two strikes.
Bases are empty, one man out. Ran it in on him as this is bounced toward short. Fielded cleanly, and the throw forces him to lay out for that one, but he keeps a foot on the bag to record the out. Riding in once again, Nick Lavella. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Two out, nobody on. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. 11 innings in the books now, and we are all tied at three apiece. Andrew Schwab gets the ball as he'll take over to start this 12th inning.
Number 25, Andrew Schwab.
Now at the plate, Jose Antequera attempting to, as they say, get off the schneid here. 0-for-5 so far. The 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full. Logan Forsythe will be next. Hard hit ball to second. He's got it. And there's one gone to start the 12. Digging in, Logan Forsythe. Four hits already in this one and looking for number five here. One out, nobody on. Fouled off. And it's fouled away. Skied into straightaway right. Duran is there. Two down. So coming to the plate, Danny Mayer. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Bat explodes as this has popped up. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So they breeze through this half of the inning. Still one run can win this thing as we move ahead to the bottom of inning number 12. And we are all tied at three apiece. J.D. Hammer will be summoned here to start the home 12th. And the best case scenario for him is to take us to the 13th.
J.D. Hammer.
Daner Lopez will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. The 1-1. Pulled toward right center field. Gutierrez is there and he has it for the first down. Striding forward now is the DH, Marco Hernandez. He flew out in his last at bat. Bases are empty, one man out. Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. The 3-1 pitch. And a good pitch there as they come after him and the count goes full.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. And there's his first base hit in this one. He'll get it into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Man, it looked like the pitcher was trying to get him to go fishing in a pitch out of the strike zone. He went for it all right, but he managed to catch all of that baseball, lacing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
Into the box, Brett Netzer. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. He just threw that fastball by him. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Ken Platt is on deck. Slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
It's never a good look to strike out looking, but it's way worse when you do it with a guy in scoring position. Those are the times you really want to see a guy battle and at least put the ball in play.
At the plate now, Ken Platt. Count even at 2-2. Swing and a liner. That gets down, and the inning will continue. And they will walk off with game one here at home.
Man,
man, the postseason always seems to deliver big moments, and this was no exception. A walk-off in the final at-bat ends it, and there's Bedlam at home plate. Wow!
Close game like this, you look for that one guy who produced when it mattered most, and this is the guy. He's our Topps player of the game.
Well, he blasted a couple of balls over the wall in this one, really put the guys on his back and carried him to the victory.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ballgame. The Sea Dogs jump out to a 1-0 series lead. Andrew Schwab gets the W on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Final line score, first to the victorious Sea Dogs, 4 runs, 12 hits, no errors, they left 8 men on base. For the Fighting, 3 runs, 11 hits, no errors, they left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 3 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.